Hi, myself Apurva Jyoti. Hope you're all fine, right? So please stay at home, be safe, use sanitizer. Whenever you're going out, please use mask and be safe. Eat healthy, be healthy. So quickly start up with the lesson today. That is the remaining part we are going to do. Qutub Shahis of Golconda, 1512 to 1687. Qutub Shahis. So Qutub Shahi's timeline they have given down, from which period to which period they have ruled and all. Quli Qutub Shah, 1512 to 1543. From 1512, from that year to 1543, he have ruled. From 1512 to 1543, he ruled. Who? Quli Qutub Shah. Jamshed Quli, 1543 to 1550. Ibrahim Qutub Shah, 1550 to 1580. So from this year to this year they have ruled. Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah, Muhammad Qutub Shah, Abdullah Qutub Shah, Abdul Hassan Thana Shah. All these people, they ruled the Golconda from the years, from which year to which year they ruled, they have given mentioned in the box there. In the previous chapter we read about the Kakatiya kingdom in the Telangana region. After the end of Kakatiya kingdom, some of their subordinates, Nayakas, established independent kingdoms. Yes, we have learnt about Kakatiya kingdom and all, right? So after the end of the Kakatiya kingdom, when this Kakatiya kingdom was end, completely finished, because all the other kings defeated them, no? When this Kakatiya kingdom was end, the subordinates like Nayakas and all will be there, no? After the king. So those people, they became independent. Means now we all know that Nayakas have been allotted with one area. In that area, they'll be collecting the taxes, they'll be ruling. No, now king is not there. They themselves declared as, we are the kings of this area. We are the independent. We will be ruling this area. Like that. The Vellama kingdom, kingdoms of Rachakunda and Devarakunda were very strong and challenged the authority of the Vijayanagara emperors and Bahamana kings. So this Vellamana kingdom, which is there, it is very strong and challenging. They accept the challenges and they're very strong. Though there are many problems, they're strong. They fight strong, right? So they are very strong and they are challenging the authority, higher people of whom Vijayanagara emperor and Buddha. Bahamana kings, they're challenging. We are ready to face the problems. Who are challenging? Vellamana kingdoms. Around the year 1512, Quli Qutub Shah, who was a governor of Bahamanis in Telangana region, declared independence and established the Qutub Shahi dynasty of Golconda. So in 1512, what happened? This Quli Qutub Shah, who's there, he was the governor of Bahamanis. He was the governor of Bahamanis of Telangana. So he is one of the governor of that Bahamani kingdom, which is in Telangana. He declared independence and he started rule, established Quli Qutub Shahi dynasty. Means his kingdom he started establishing. He declared independence and he started preparing his own kingdom. Quli Qutub Shah extended his rule by capturing forts at Warangal, Kondapalli, Eluru and Rajahmundry. So this Quli Qutub Shah, who is there, he started spreading his rule slowly. He started capturing, taking the forts, palaces of different kings under his control, like Warangal fort, Kondapalli, Eluru and Rajahmundry. In these places, what all the forts are there, palaces are there, he started taking them under his control. The main parts of Golconda state was Telangana. So this Golconda state, wherever these Bahamanis and all are ruling, no, those are Golconda states, right? So was the main part, which is the main one, is what? Telangana. His successor ruled. Successor means after him, right? His successor ruled up to 1687. So after him, after Quli Qutub Shah, next one of Quli Qutub Shah, next ruler of that Bahamani kingdom, he ruled up to which year 1687 to that year he have ruled. Down they have given the map, you see, Qutub Shahi dynasty. Sultan Ibrahim Qutub Shah 1550 patronized Telugu literature, supported Bahmanis and temples, and engaged in large scale irrigation works like the Kakatiya kingdoms. So even the Sultan Ibrahim Qutub Shah, who is there, he also encouraged temples, he also patronized Telugu literatures, he also encouraged Telugu language, temples, he started building temples, large irrigational works like constructing of tanks, dams for the people, like Kakatiya kingdom, he also encouraged temples and all. Famous Telugu poets of Ibrahim Qutub Shahi period were Singanacharyudu. So even though they are Muslims, they are encouraging Telugu literature, very great work, no? So under his king, in his kingdom, there are famous Telugu poets. One of them is Singanacharyudu, Addanki Gangadharudu, Kandukuri Rudra Kavi, and Ponnaganti were patronized by Ibrahim Qutub Shah. So these are the great poets who are in his kingdom. Ibrahim Qutub Shah was praised by poets as Malkiba Rama. So all those, this Ibrahim Qutub Shah is being praised by all the poets. All the poets are praising, means they are giving a good name to Malkiba Rama. That name they have given to whom? Ibrahim Qutub Shah. He also took into his service many Nayaka chieftains who proudly claimed descent from warriors, supporters of the Kakatiyas, especially those serving Prataparudra. So not only this, the Kakatiya ruler who is a Prataparudra, under him the warriors who are working, for them also he have provided work, the chieftains, warriors, supporters who are there of Kakatiya ruler. He took them into his kingdom, trained them, and he have given them work. Ibrahim allowed them considerably autonomy in the agrarian sphere, while all entrusting them with the command of great forts. So he not only have taken them into the army or the troop, but he also have given them considerable autonomy, means self power or self decision one he have given them, entrusting them with command of great forts, means he have given a great command of fort, big forts they have given them, and they started trusting on them. If you like my video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you. We are going to learn the rest part of the lesson in the next class.